dell'Amalettia di Giacomo, l'artista per eccellenza Joseph Casapinta. Joseph è concedere l'onore in America Lentain, al di nella fedace di Guerra Solo, legge presenta Danne de Fecci, di Kashkar Storia, Littul Lannati. Oggi nel Guerra il tema è i Watercolour Story, ma fna asmi l'abdagia nel Danne Palazzo, a scuola acquarelle, tabilha e racconta storia unica. Minu in realtà Joseph Casapinta. Sinceramente, manaf, che flanqas manaf minjenie. U dan għax il-burdati f'kun bniedem li jinbidlu ma' kuljum jagħmluh differenti, kemm fejn nifsu kif ukoll fl-ottika ta' nies oħra fosthom tal-familja u l-ħbieb. Li nista' ngħid fi żgur fuq Joseph hu li hu artist ċebri. Artist li baqa' dejjem saqajh fl-art minkejja li l-arti tiegħu daret ma' ħafna pajjiżi differenti fid-dinja. U għal dan il-fatt nirreferi għalih bħala artist internazzjonali. Kif irrakkunta li kemm il-darba hu stess, in-namra tiegħu għall-arti bdiet minn età bikrija meta beda jipinġu bil-linka. Minn dak iż-żmien kompla jitfarrak fl-arti sema mess mal-akrilika, żejt u watercolors. Fejn sab li svolg il-milja tiegħu kollha fil-qasam artistiku. Xi żmien ilu żortu fil-workshop tiegħu qrib il-mitta Berkerkar u stajt nosserva l-metikolezza li ħaddar. Metikolezza li tirrifletti fil-kwadri kollha li jbidder. Għatih karta ta' tpinġija u minna joħroġ il-kapolavur mill-aqwa kemm għad-dettalji, għall-kuluri, għall-aqbiet ta' maestrija u għall-indafa fejn l-abjad jibqa' safi. U bniedem tal-erba staġuni, għax kif isib il-waqt ikollu xewqa, kemm fil-qiegħ tas-sħana jew tal-ksija u x-xita, araħ jieħu flawn u lien bil-karozza, l-għodd artistika u bil-pipa, u jintefa fil-muża ħawtira tiegħu ibinter dak li jolqodlu in-niżġa ta' ħsibieru. Joħloq dak trasmess mill-vista għall-moħħ għal ħid il-pittur u jisawwar testiment imbitter għall-ġenerazzjonijiet futuri li jafu għal ħitada ma jisibux l-istess erkejjen arkitettura u xenarji li s-issa aħna mdorrin bihom. Kull aspett trattat minn Joseph Casapinta se tkunu tistgħu tammiraw aħjar u tixdu l-ħila tal-artist wara li l-Eċċellenza tagħha l-President ta' Malta Marie-Louise Coleiro preka tiddikjara l-verja miftuħa. Your Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, for the benefit of the non-Maltese speaking, I would like to welcome you to the exhibition of my friend Joseph Casapinta. I have known Joseph for quite a number of years and have followed him since. As you might all agree, Joseph has become an international artist, as he has many of his paintings sold abroad and has exhibited vastly in different foreign countries. Today he is exhibiting solo for the 11th time under the title A Watercolour Story, where each painting recounts a unique scenario or landscape. As you can see, after the inauguration by Her Excellency, the President of Malta, Joseph Casapinta's watercolors are painted in such a meticulous way that anyone who acquires one of the paintings should be proud of it. Who is some student and artist, Joseph Casapinta, we share this course.
Your Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Welcome to my 11th solo exhibition, A Watercolour Story. Each painting is derived from a special moment, from an outdoor session, the build-up of a painting, sketches or photos taken for a future reference, each career and experience back to my studio, resulting to what I am exhibiting today. Watercolour has not only become a passion, but a way of life that has grown to be part of what I am today, a watercolourist. This medium allows me to express myself freely with more vivid colors, depicting to what is so very much close to my heart, Malta and its surroundings. The exhibition is being organized in aid of the Malta Community Chess Fund, of which a substantial amount of the proceeds will be donated for this cause. I would like to thank all the team that has made this exhibition possible, Casapinta Design Group for all the setups, and the administrative staff at the office of the President. I thank you for visiting the opening, and now I kindly invite Her Excellency to inaugurate the exhibition. Thank you.
Paris toward 16th century Berlin. This has been the staples during the 16th century when Grandmaster Antoine the Horse, alive then, had bought this land and developed this building. The ground floor was dedicated to stables and also the quarters for servants. And on the first floor, what they used to call the piano nobile, where the actual living quarters were situated. So really, I feel very proud that we have welcomed our very first exhibition by Joseph Malkin. It's very befitting, Joe, to have your exhibits here. You have been a benefactor of more than just one for a very long time, so it's really just one could say a good turn, not really. I think it is truly befitting to have the very first exhibition in Sala on the board by yourself. Really, the paintings, you have to look and look at them. And it is also befitting to have this watercolor story here, because it covers mostly Maltese heritage and Maltese panoramic views, which definitely befits such magnificent part of our heritage. Joseph Casapinta, over the years, has become a cultural and arts ambassador for Malta. It is not only in Malta that you have exhibited, but your talents now are becoming very much known even beyond our shores. So really, I feel very privileged and honored to have been invited to open this exhibition. I really would like to enjoy the evening and join by really delving deep in these wonderful watercolor pictures by Joseph that really depict some very interesting and profound Maltese scenery. I have this experience regularly when I visit schools and engage with children and young people in our education institutions. I engage with them in conversation, and most of the time, if not all the time, because it is practically all the time, they speak to me about the environment. They speak to me about open spaces. They speak to me about preserving our heritage in terms of the natural environment, but also our historical environment. So really, this would be an opportunity for even school children and young people to visit so that they can at least enjoy these beautiful scenes of our natural environment, but also of our historical heritage. I feel when I look at such paintings, I always remember what our children are telling us about the environment. And I feel that we as adults have a great responsibility. And Joseph, through these pictures, you are preserving these wonderful, beautiful spots in our country, preserving them also in such a beautiful way in your artistic, these profound artistic abilities of yours, which to me are very much needed. Some probably of the sceneries that we are seeing here might not be as beautiful as in these pictures now, due to sometimes overdevelopment. So really preserving such beautiful scenes to me has a lot of meaning. I really would love to see young students, children to come, school children to come and take a look, so that they can become even more, they can be even more active on and about the environment. I really would like to share such beautiful paintings with them, so that they can continue to speak about the need that we should preserve our natural heritage and our natural environment. as I always say, we have borrowed Malta, or rather we are borrowing Malta from them, so we need as adults to really take care of what is being loaned to us in terms. Joseph, thank you so much for depicting such beautiful scenery, such beautiful national heritage with your wonderful ability to paint and bring to life such beautiful pictures. Thank you and yourself.
It's a beautiful scene of the palace, Anton palace.